spark our interest and head to MakerWorks.
Hey friends, today we're back in MakerWorks with my friend Miss Kendal. We're gonna learn all about electricity. Now, I know electricity powers my lights and my games.
Yeah.
But what does it come from?
That's a great question, Simon. So, before we start talking about electricity, we're going to have to get really, really small.
Oh.
As small as we possibly can, because first, we're going to talk about atoms. Do you know what an atom is, Simon?
Yeah, I got a friend named Adam.
Not a name. An atom is the smallest particle of matter, and it's where we get our electricity. So, our atom is composed of three different parts. We have a positively charged proton. We have a neutrally charged neutron. And together, the proton and the neutron make up the nucleus, or the center of our atom.
Oh, the nucleus is in the center.
That's right. Now, for our purposes today, talking about electricity, these next guys are the really important ones because surrounding or orbiting our nucleus are our electrons.
Electrons?
That's right, and electrons are negatively charged.
Oh.
Mm-hmm. But even though they're negative, they're always searching for the positive, Simon.
That's pretty funny.
And that's where we get electricity from, the flow of electrons.
Oh!
So today we're going to look a little bit at static electricity.
Static electricity?
Mm-hmm. So static electricity is when those electrons jump from their atom to someplace else, someplace positively charged.
Oh, because they're looking for the positive.
Exactly right. So, let's get some things that we might have around the house because we're going to do a little bit of an experiment, Simon.
Okay.
All right. So, what we're going to need, we're going to need a balloon.
A balloon.
Mm-hmm. Some tissue paper.
Tissue paper.
But if you don't have tissue paper, paper towel or Kleenex will work as well.
How about toilet paper?
Toilet paper might work too, Simon.
Cool.
You're going to need some tape.
Tape.
A marker.
Marker.
And a pair of scissors.
Oh, watch out for the pointy parts.
That's right. And if you need help, just ask your mom and dad. So the first thing you're going to do is you're going to draw a design onto your tissue paper or whatever paper you're going to use. So I'm going to draw something pretty easy. I'm going to draw a heart.
That's so nice.
Because I love talking about science. Then we're going to cut out our shape.
Electrifying.
Simon. That was pretty funny. All right, so we're being really careful, right, Simon?
Yeah, careful. Watch those scissors.
Watch those scissors to cut out our shape. Now, we're going to make our shapes dance.
What?
We're going to make them dance using static electricity.
I like to dance.
Simon, I'm so glad you said that because look what Miss Kendal cut out earlier just for you. Shapes. So you're going to take your shape, take a little piece of tape, and we're going to tape the shape down to the table or whatever surface you're working on.
Okay.
We just want to make sure you can't go anywhere.
Yeah.
Now, blow up your balloon. I blew up mine earlier.
Oh.
Because we're going to use our balloon to build up our static charge. So, the best way to build up that static charge is to rub it on your head.
What?
We're going to rub our balloon on our head.
So
I'm building up all of those negative particles. And now, let's see if we can get those negative particles to find the positive.
I'm dancing.
You're dancing, Simon. Good job. So static electricity is making our shape dance.
That's so funny.
Isn't that cool? So static electricity, this is a fun experiment that you guys can try at home. What other types of things do you think you can make move using the power of static electricity? Let us know, guys. We would love to hear from you. Hope you have fun trying this electrifying experiment at home. Bye, guys. We'll see you later.